Greetings, we are from University Putra Malaysia campus in Tulu, Sarawak, and today we'll be presenting our slides regarding agriculture waste management on managing sargohampas and palm oil decanter cake through sterilization using black sojafly larvae, or also known as Hermitia elucens, under the supervision of Dr. Latifah Omar and Professor Dr. Ahmed Pasamuno Haruna. Introducing my groupmate, Wisbini Anak Perempuan Lohananten, Kurt YG, and myself, Muhammad Hashwin bin Hassan. Globally, 998 million tons of agriculture waste is produced in a year. And in Malaysia, it is estimated that 1.2 million tons of agriculture waste is disposed into the landfill annually. The problem is that the waste are not treated properly and will cause environmental pollution. The problem regarding agriculture waste, especially in the sago plantation and oil palm plantation industry, it is they dispose the waste into the nearest river, which will cause the stream of oxygen content to decrease and several drop in water quality. Besides, it also endangered the aquatic life and released unpleasant smell, which also caused algae blooms. Although there are solutions for this problem, such as biogas production, it normally constrained by the requirement of high skillful technician, and it will cost a huge amount of expenses. Luckily, there's an affordable solution for this problem, which is FRAS production as soil amendment. Well, what is FRAS? FRAS is an alternative to compost that are less explored. It can be used in managing soil condition and limiting the use of chemical fertilizer. Besides, it's able to turn over organic waste. FRAS is an excrement of insect larvae which can be obtained through the digestive system of black sojafly larvae when there is dry matter or feedstock has been processed by it. In addition, it is high in nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium with the ratio of 5 to 2, making it as good as fertilizer for specific plant and soil characteristics. This is some of the example of FRAS from BSF larvae which can be seen in the market. Black sojafly larvae or Hermitia elucens is categorized under the Dipterium family and order Stratomidae. The life cycle of black sojafly consists of four phases, which is egg, larvae, pupa and adult stage. The black sojafly larvae are considered as bio-waste recycler in current waste management practice, also known as bioconversion. The figure shows how a black sojafly larvae looks like, and remarkably, they can degrade any organic waste and excrete it into FRAS at the end of the larvae stage. So, why managing sargohampas and oil palm decanter cake through sterilization with black sojafly larvae is a good idea, you ask? First of all, because they are prodigious consumer of organic matter, they can convert extra energy from organic residue such as bio-waste residue and can be raised in organic waste for it to feed on with high degradation rate between 66% until 79%, which the larvae in the end will produce dropping in a form of FRAS. Besides, they are capable of overcoming pathogen present in the waste, and they are one of the most efficient organic recycler. In addition, their morphological features and physiological function enable the larvae to digest diverse organic matter. Although the bioconservation process can be affected by type, quality and quantity of the feed.
There is scanty information about FRAS production. Therefore, the objectives are to determine the stabilization process of FRAS produced from different proportion of sargohampas, oil palm decanter cake and BSF larvae, and to evaluate the phytotoxicity effects of FRAS produced from different proportion of sargohampas, decanter cake and similar BSF larvae in lactose germination.
So now we continue with the material and method. So these are the pictures showing that the material and apparatus of railing black sojafly larvae. So what are the procedure we need to railing the black sojafly larvae? The first thing, of course, we need to prepare the starter culture, and we choose sago starch and some fruits such as banana because they are more easier to digest by the young larvae, and the young larvae need to be grown until become the first instar or second instar stage for us to transfer them into the main substrate, which are decanter cake and sargohampas. So once they are transferred into the main substrate, we'll let the larvae to undergo the composting process itself until the larvae turn into the pre-pupa or pupa. So once they turn into pupa, they will indicate a dark brown color as shown in the picture below. So once they show this color, we can actually do harvest our FRAS, and the FRAS can be undergoes the physical, chemical and biological tests so that we can identify either the FRAS is mature or stable to be used. So other than physical and chemical tests, of course we have biological tests, which is phytotoxicity test. We will use the ready seed and then we will plant on the prejudice with filter paper moisture by 10 mL of 10% plus extraction. Then will be incubated at 25 degrees Celsius under dark chamber conditions, and after 96 hours of incubation, the germinated seed amount and the length radicals were measured, so that we can calculate the germination index by the formula below. And now let's look about the result and discussion. So the average temperature for the frost throughout the composting period for the dechanter cane and Cyber One Plus is almost the same. The daily average temperature of frost, both of them have daily average temperatures around 27 degrees Celsius to 30 degrees Celsius. And this has been proved by Lalander et al. 2013. The black soldier fly larvae prefer temperature between 25 to 30 degrees Celsius to perform rapid biodegradation process. And actually this is a good sign because it's showing that our temperature is very good for black soldier fly growth. The Cyber One Plus originally was yellowish color, they will change into dark reddish brown color when it becomes frost. And the texture also turned into fine fibers. And for the dechanter cane, they originally they are black colored and they turn into blank color also because in the end of the frost. However, the texture that actually changed into crumbly is very obvious. And this has been proved by Hong and Lee about the dark color frost indicates the substrate has reached maturity or fully digested and changed the overall properties of the substrate. So besides that, the dark coloration also indicates the substrate are consists of mainly water retained organic matter. So the rest of the physical chemical properties of the frost are shown in this, so in this table. So this is the frost of Cyber One Plus. So basically, all of them are very good, just the CN ratio is very too high, because normally the CN ratio of the mature compost are lower than 20 to 1. So basically all of these are exceed than 20 to 1 is very high. So it's basically indicates that it's not good to use as a frost. It's not mature yet. And the second thing is the electric conductivity for this frost is actually too high, because normally the mature compost is lower than 4 microsiemens per cm, and these all of them are larger than 4 microsiemens per cm, so that the EC need to be lower too to become more mature. And for the dechanter cane, they have the same problem, which is on the EC part, which is electrical conductivity is too high, because their EC is 2000 microsiemens per cm, so it's too high. This is a phytotoxicity test for the cyclophrase treatment. So basically all of them are toxic, because every treatment their germination index are lower than 50%. That's why all of them are toxic due to the high EC. Because when you have a high electrical conductivity, basically you have high soluble salts, and these high soluble salts will interrupt the seed to obtain the nutrients for the frost. And for the phytotoxicity of the dechanter cane frost, basically only the frost with the initial extract, which is without the dilution, are toxic, and rest of them with dilution are not toxic. Because without the dilution, the EC is very high, the soluble salt is too high. That's why they cannot uptake any nutrients from the frost, and through the osmosis, and eventually it will die or it will not germinate. Okay.
Let's move on to the impact of the study. Frost production is one of the alternative approach to manage sago and oil palm vases to produce valuable end product by using BSF larvae as decomposer agent, which can be added into an organic fertilization. The focus of this research was on the frost potential to be used as organic fertilizer. As a conclusion, dechanter cane and Cyber One Plus can be used as rearing substrate for BSF larvae to complete their life cycle at 45 days before the larvae enter pupa stage. Frost after being fed on dechanter cane have good physical and chemical properties and viable for seed germination. The suitable pH and sufficient nutrient in dechanter cane provide source of energy for BSF larvae to complete their larva stage and produce good agronomic properties of frost. There are 5 parameters which are important in order to make frost, which is CN ratio, total organic matter, pH, temperature and moisture content. Frost from Cyber One Plus is toxic towards plant. However, the frost from dechanter cane is not toxic towards the plant. Unlike dechanter cane frost, Cyber One Plus frost need to do another cycle due to the high fiber and lignin content in the Cyber One Plus. Following are the references that we used throughout the experiment. That's all from us. Thank you.